But then he starts playing the song, and then they start dancing.
Do a cartoon dance. He flips her around, and
like it's all kinds of like it's it starts out as legitimate dancing, and then gets cartoonish.
Yeah,
to the point where he spins her up in the air, and she's like floating and spinning around, and he's like, and he's like looking at a clock and going, "Oh, I should catch her now," and then catches her and shit like that, and.
All the while, Dorian is watching his girlfriend dance with this cartoon person.
Well, no, he hasn't actually done that. He was there, and then he got called upstairs during her first number.
Oh, right.
And this is where he finds Freeze slash the doctor, and it's just like, he's half dead.
Somebody beat us to the thing.
And his plan is to give him a cigarette.
And he's like, here, suck on this, and then
he doesn't even get to light it. He goes, I'm gonna kill him. Who was it? And he grabs his buddy, and it's like, hey, it's him. That's the guy pointing. It's like, the guy dancing with Tina? Yeah, that's him.
Boy, he's dead meat.
How convenient.
Yeah. Because, no, well, even you can hear it in the goon's voice, like, oh, shit, he's like, right there.
That's actually him, yeah.
Boss, it's him. It's but actually like, him.
What my question is, if the mask wasn't dancing with her, what was he going to, how was he going to get out of this?
I don't know.
Yeah.
So Dorian and his crew come down, clear everyone out with guns as.
Well, the mask kisses Tina first.
Yeah.
And then he starts doing it, which is a big plot point.
And then they just start shooting.
Well, he just said, like, they shoot the tie.
Yeah.
Because the tie cuts, and I don't like this, even though it clearly has to happen, I don't like how, like, they shoot off the tie, and then it turns back into Stanley's pajamas.
Yeah.
I don't like that, that doesn't make sense. But,
well, it does in a way, because it's just like, well, it's been cut, and now it's back to reality for that fabric of clothing.
But in a world where he can morph into anything and he can control the world around him, I can't see how that would happen.
Well, I mean, he'd be distracted by getting shot at to, like, not control.
I don't know.
It's weird to apply logic to something like this.
It really is. It's hard to do, but you would think, like, in a world where, like I'm going with, like, say, Superman logic. You know, like, there's an aura around Superman that his clothing is protected because of his, like, that's why when he gets shot... You know, his clothes don't rip.
Yeah.
Right? Like, you would think that there would be something like that. Well,
the mask does, because again, when he gets shot later in the film, there's still holes. It just doesn't affect him.
Yeah, it seems odd to me, though. But anyway.
So he's, you know, turning into a bullfighter, and he's blocking the bullets, and he turns into whatever, and then he turns into a cowboy, and then he gets hit, and he's like, oh! And I like that Dorian's like, yeah, we got him!
Got him! And then he just sort of goes, and falls on him like, that is genius.
Falls into Orlando's arms and just starts quoting movies.
Yeah. Like, I don't think Tiny Tim will be home this Christmas. Like,
tell Scarlet Tell Scarlet I do give a damn.
And then he fucking dies.
Well, he's like
Well, because
like coughs in his face.
He's been constantly coughing away from his face, and then the last one, he just smiles and then coughs in his face, and then farts and goes, "Pardon me."
I love that he farts and goes, "Pardon me."
And then he dies, and then I don't understand how any of this makes any sense.
No, none of this. None of this makes sense.
A fake audience pops up, like a really tiny fake audience. He's handed an Oscar, and everyone's applauding, and they can see it. Because Dorian starts fixing his hair.
Dorian looks at the crowd and he starts fixing his hair. Like, and Orlando starts, like, fixing his clothes because the audience is now there.
What are they seeing?
I don't know.
Like, this baffled me since I was a kid. What the fuck are they looking at?
I don't know.
It is the strangest thing ever.
And then he just kind of flies out of there. Like, gotta go! And then comically bounces out of the club. Calloway comes in. Catches Dorian and his crew all shooting at this cartoon person who I don't think they see.
No, they don't. They just say, drop it, Terrell. And he goes, you robbed the bank. And he goes, why don't you try doing some police work? I didn't do it this time.
And the weird thing is, the cop that says, boss, we got a stiff upset, he looks like Jim Carrey.
Yeah, really does.
Like the cop who finds everything, like, boss, we got a stiff upstairs. I'm like, is that Jim? No.
To be fair, could be a stunt double.
Okay.
Could actually
be. Because I'm like, this guy looks like Jim Carrey, and he kind of sounds like him, too.
Yeah.
And they got him dead to rights because they got a fucking dead body.
Mm-hmm. But mind you, the cops killed him, so it doesn't really work.
No, well, that's why they let him go.
Yeah.
But he finds the PJs. Because it's all a MacGuffin, you know? It's I got to pin... Well, got to find something to pin Stanley to the club.
That's what I said. Like, now, I understand why it happened.
You don't question how Stanley Ipkiss was in the club, the Coco Bongo Club, in his nautical-themed pajamas?
Yeah. I mean... There's a lot. I mean,
either way, he goes to see him, and you know, he wakes up and he sees the money's in the thing, and he gotta like
he's trying to get the money. And this is where Milo grabs the frisbee, which was not intended to happen, and it works insanely well.
Well, because Milo's like, oh, frisbee time.
Yeah, because Milo is there trying, as it looks like he's just sort of getting in the way as he's using the frisbee to try and put the money back in the closet. But then Milo grabs a hold of it, and he just sort of goes, no, 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 drop it, like he usually does, and it works insanely well. And like, I'm glad they kept that in the movie.
Opens the door. Mm-hmm. Kellaway walks into the apartment, which, no.
Yeah.
No.
That's not happening.
Do you have a warrant?
Yeah.
Well, then no.
You don't get to come in, jackass. And you can't get a warrant based on fucking pajamas.
No, he's just like, there's no way two idiots in this city has these pajamas. I'm like,
yes,
what is your hang? What is your hang up about this guy's pajamas?
He doesn't like them, so therefore it's not possible. I'm like, Jesus. No pajama company in the world makes just one pair.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I guarantee you, more than one asshole, probably listen, in that city, bought those pajamas.
It's 1994, so Amazon's not a thing. Yeah. So he would have went to a store to buy those pajamas. And I'm sure someone else bought those exact same pajamas.
Yeah. Like, it happens. That is nothing. That you're basing this on nothing.
Well, like most cops, yeah, I really. Guess. Substantial evidence.
Yeah.
Not substantial, that's wrong.
No, it's
circumstantial.
Circumstantial.
Evidence. So him and his fucking dumb partner, Doyle, are just like, well, I don't think we got him, or whatever.
Yeah.
Doyle is like the fucking...
He's the...
Barney Fife.
Yeah, like, very much so.
Bumbling sidekick.
Constantly trying to get food.
Yeah.
Shit like that.
And he's like, yeah, but I ordered onion rings, let's go!
Like, no, to be fair, you wait for fucking onion rings. Onion rings are delicious, fuck you. And you're basing it on nothing, damn it.
So, well, I guess Dorian wants the mask, I guess?
Yeah, he basically, he offers, much like we see in a few years later with The Dark Knight, they offer a metric fuck ton of money. He offers like 50 grand for
anyone who finds the mask, brings him here alive.
And
it's like, tell every hood in the city.
And I do like this, he was just like, you're still here.
Go!
Like, that's genius. I like that.
You know, for like a two-dimensional villain... Mm-hmm. Not even, kind of one-dimensional.
Yeah.
This guy's really good.
He is actually really good for given nothing.
Yeah.
Especially because now we get, like, with Tina, because Tina's just like, you're really losing it, Dorian. And she does something that, like, I'm like, somebody should have actually coached her a little better, because she does something that no one would ever do. When she says, like, you're really losing it, Dorian, she's got a pack of cigarettes in her hand, pulls out a cigarette, doesn't try to light it, puts it back down, and grabs a magazine. No smoker in the history of smokers has ever done that.
Yeah. Or like, she should have, like, here, you need this.
Yeah, either give it to him, or light it, or something, or don't have the cigarettes, just pick up the magazine. It's just a really weird thing that kind of always irks me.
So Stanley, kind of feeling the pressure of, like, because whenever he comes out of the mask and the dreams and stuff, or whatever he thinks they are.
Well, he's driving him nuts.
Yeah, he's like, he's disheveled and he's beat up.
Yeah.
Mentally, physically. And the boss goes, yeah, you're late again. He's like, listen here!
Yeah, like... Maybe I should tell your daddy how you're running this bank.
Basically going, like, you're skimming off the top here. Yeah. You go to club bed, you understand?
Yeah. Like, he's just like, I'm gonna fucking call the cops on you. And then he goes, well, that'll be all, Lipkis.
Yeah. And then Charlie's like, wow, where did this come from? Like,
whose bed, what side of whose bed did you wake up this morning?
Although he's like, you look like shit. Tina, again, goes to see Stanley.
Mm-hmm. And they're way too familiar by this point.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I don't like this because I'm like, I feel like there was more scenes that should have happened because they're way, way, way too familiar now.
And she wants to know about the mask, and he's like, I know him, you know.
Well, he doesn't even get to that point yet. She's just like, oh, I don't think I'm going to have much to open an account.
Yeah.
And I'm like, why is she going to him? What is the fucking point of this? She clearly hasn't put her name on anything. She hasn't
also
done anything.
You've met this guy twice.
Yeah,
but now you're worried about your boyfriend. Really. So you're running to the geeky guy at the bank.
Yeah, she's trying to get advice from him or something. And it's like, there is no reason she would go here. None. Absolutely no reason.
Also, it doesn't make any sense that she goes, I think the mask was at the club last night. I'm like no, you know the mask was at the club last night.
You were dancing with and made out with him.
You was smooching with him.
Yeah, I think you noticed that it was him.
So, and then this is where he's like, you know, I know him, you know.
I know him, you know. And then it's like...
So,
and then,
college buddy. And I'm like, that thing is not anybody's college buddy.
But I do enjoy the little...
At where? Looney Tune U? Where did you go?
Hey, Acme University.
That's true.
And I want to go there. But no, I do like, it's a little bit of a pimp move. We're getting a little bit of what he becomes, where he's just like, it's funny you mentioned the dance moves, and then he fucking busts out one of the moves. I taught him a few myself. I'm like, that's pimped? That is a little too pimped for this character.
But then it gets cut off because she's just like, well, can you help me meet him? And he's like, oh.
Well, not really. He is and he isn't. He's like a little bit like, because it's one of those.
Well, he knows he's the mask. Yeah. But she doesn't know he's the mask. It's like Superman, she's asking for him, but not directly. Yeah. Indirectly asking for Stanley.
Yeah.
We'll meet at the park, sunset, the whole thing. Landfill Park.
Yeah. So, the park, sunset, perfect.
So he goes to Dr. Arthur Newman, who we saw on the TV earlier talking about masks. And he's just asking about what masks, this is.
Metaphorically speaking.
So we get Ben Stein in his, being his Ben Steiniest.
That's what you do.
Like, well, this looks like it's ancient Sumerian or whatever, Scandinavian.
It's like the it's night like, god Loki. And he's like, Loki?
God of mischief. God of mischief. And like, then he's like, okay, well, I'm going to show you something.
He's like, well, this is all metaphorical.
Yes.
And he's like, well, I'll show you. See you on the other side. And then he tries to put it on, and like the music builds and everything like that. Nothing. And he goes, and then he tries it again, and he goes,
I love that he's like,
and he's dancing around. He's like, and you can see Ben Stein going, uh-huh. He goes, well, you said he was a night god. Maybe it only works at night.
Well, I can't help you, but I can send you to a medical professional.
Would you like somewhere safe? I can arrange somewhere safe for you tonight if you'd like. No, I have to meet Tina. Like, Jesus Christ.
Should I be the mask or myself? Or myself for the mask? He's like,
if I tell you, do you promise to leave right now?
Yes.
Of course. You should go as yourself and the mask. Because they're one and the same beautiful person.
Now like please leave my office, you nut job. Who I'm assuming, both then and now, how most conversations end with Jim Carrey with regular people.
I would bet money on that.
So the cops follow Stanley. This is where Doyle's mad. Because I ordered onion rings. Get in the car!
Aww. I'm on Doyle's side in this shit, man.
Onion rings are delicious.
Mm-hmm.
So Stanley and Tina are in the park. Yeah. And she's kind of weird, like, Stanley,
what are you doing here? And I'm like, wow. You're the one who went to him like you're fucking star-crossed lovers, bitch.
Fuck you! What do you mean, what am I doing here? I just wanted to make sure you got here, and my buddy's, he's coming soon.
He's running a little late.
Now, here's where she doesn't put two and two together.
No.
Because he runs off. He's like, runs into the smallest... Well,
no, they're having a nice conversation where they're talking about the landfill park.
Yeah.
And, like... She's actually, like, and this is where I don't understand, because I guess this is sort of like he's too uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Because she's actually having a nice conversation with him and not telling him to leave. Like, she doesn't want him to leave. And he does. And he fucking runs in and goes, yes, the smallest bush ever. And he clearly puts on the mask.
And you can see, like, the thing flying out, and then he comes out as the mask on the other end. You're just like... Well, logically speaking,
you clearly know what happened.
Stanley's gone, the mask is here.
Yeah. Like...
It's so weird.
It's the Clark Kent Superman thing. Because where you can't see it.
He's got the handkerchief on the neck, and he's got the beret, I am French now. And it's so weird because at the beginning, she seems off-put. Because he's
extremely.
He's being super Pepe Le Pew about this.
Yeah, well, that's the problem, right? And he's just like, you know, like, is it fate? Is it, destiny? Is it written in the stars that we are destined to fraternize? And then, I'd like to think so. And then she fucking knees him in the nuts.
Yeah.
And he turns to the camera. She is so kind. And this is when...
She is so good.
Yeah. And then this is where he fucking smokes the cigarette, which apparently was ad-libbed as well, because he's like, can we do this? So he smokes it and fucking breathes it into a heart and then sucks the shoots it out of his nose, this arrow through it. And then she's like lightening up.
Yeah.
And this is where window. I don't care.
But at the end, you can see she's like half smiling and like
kind of down with it now. It's very confusing. And then this is where fucking Kellaway pops in and just goes, hey, freeze. And he goes, nailed. And he jumps up and freezes in midair. And of course, icicles and shit form on him. And then he's just like, put your hands up. But you told me to freeze.
Oh, no, freeze.
What in the flying fuck? You don't notice this man hovering.
Or frozen. I was frozen today.
Yeah, like, and I mean, what? Tina fucks off, and no one seems to question her.
Well, she sees cops with guns.
No, whatever. I understand, but why wouldn't the cops go, hey, Mitch, get your ass back here.
What are you doing with this nut job?
Yeah.
Okay, unfreeze.
And he fucking does.
And then, all right, cuff him. And take his stuff out of his pockets.
And it's this comical amount of shit. And I like how his reactions to it are great.